Good afternoon, parents of students that are arriving for 2021's Year 7. I'm Paul Reedy, the Principal of Mount St Patrick College. I'm very proud to be Principal of this great college, and we hope that your children have a really rich experience and they are able to flourish and reach their potential in their time at the college. There's lots of great history here. My office is actually in Presentation House when the sisters first came to form the school nearly 100 years ago. So we're very proud of our heritage here, and we hope that your children will be very proud to be part of Mount St Pat's history itself. Today you're going to get some information about the various interests and things that happen at the college, because there's lots of things, sport, cultural, academic, that your children will be able to achieve at and take those opportunities on, I hope. Your guides for the day will be Sam and Olivia, our school captains for next year, and I'm sure they'll give you a great rundown on the college. Thank you.
Hello Year 7 2021. We are your school captains, Olivia Flannery
and Sam Anderson. And let us take you around the school.
Follow us.
This building is Presentation House. It was built in 1904.
Look, there's Miss Shirah.
Welcome parents and students of 2021 Year 7. My name's Narelle Shirah and I'm the Assistant Principal of Learning and Teaching at the College. Mount St Patrick College has a long history of being the top academic school on the North Coast as far as our HSC results are concerned, but it's not all about HSC results. We endeavour to cater for the needs of all students, and our main goal is that every student grows and reaches their potential. So if your child has particular academic needs, we endeavour to cater for those. We have a great intervention program for literacy and numeracy aimed at trying to bring students up to their potential, and we try to extend the top students and cater for every student. In Year 7, the students are placed into learning groups based on literacy. There's just one advanced group, and that's based on the NAPLAN results in Year 5 and the input from the primary school teacher. If you have any additional information, you can direct it to me and we'll take that into account if you think your child should be placed in that advanced class. But don't be concerned if they're not placed in that class at first and you think that they have potential. We will move students in Year 8 and place them in the appropriate learning level once we see how they're progressing. We know that some students are very good at literacy and not so good at maths and vice versa, so at the end of Term 1 we'll have a small assessment task where students will then be placed in their appropriate maths groups. So the students participate in the following subjects, okay, in Year 7, which are the mandatory courses. So English, Maths, Science, HSIE, and then we have PDHPE, Technology, Art and Music, and Religion. So quite a variety of subjects, and it's probably something that the students enjoy, moving around the school, having 8 different teachers, and doing different subjects, and hopefully they'll choose what their favourite subject is. So I'd like to welcome you all. At the start of next year, we will have an information night where you'll get to meet your child's teachers, hear about what's going to be taught in those subjects, and we'll talk about assessment and homework. But at the moment, just get really excited about your child coming to high school, and we look forward to seeing them soon. Thank you.
This is the Sacred Heart Church.
It's where we hold our college masses. Is that OD?
Hello everyone, I'm Mick O'Donoghue and I'm the leader of evangelisation here at Mount St Pat's. So being a Catholic and a Christian school, the basis of what we do here, or really the reason we really exist, is the life and teachings of Jesus Christ. And so my role, along with Mrs. Angela Finkel, who's the leader of catechesis, my role is just to try and help staff and students come to, I suppose, a deeper understanding and hopefully an appreciation of the importance and the value of those teachings. So I suppose, what does that involve for our college? It involves things like masses, liturgies. Our Year 10 and 12 go away on retreats. We have reflection days for our other classes. And of course it involves all those things that we do in classrooms, that the actual teaching of RE lessons, which Mrs. Finkel looks after. As you can see behind me here, we're very fortunate to have our church, and also very fortunate to have our parish priest, Father Anthony, who certainly does a wonderful job of trying to live out what the college is really on about. Myself and Angela are also helped in our roles here by our youth ministry officers, our YMOs, and this year it's Cassidy and Cooper. And they're just going to say a few little words about what they do. So myself, Angela, the YMOs and all the staff, we believe here at college that a deeper appreciation and understanding of these teachings can certainly, as it says in St. John's Gospel, to help us live life to the full. So yeah, I look forward to working with your sons and daughters next year.
Hi guys, we're the YMOs at Mount St. Patrick College this year. I'm Cooper.
And I'm Cassidy. So basically our role within the college is to spend time with the students and to be a source of support for them on their faith journeys. We go to classes and we just pretty much spend time with them and run prayer experiences and run icebreakers to allow them to encounter God.
During lunch times we also like to go and hang out with the students, and students are also given the opportunity to go on many retreats. We are all looking forward to be working alongside your sons and daughters next year. God bless.
This is our school garden.
Here is our school bus. We take it on sporting events and school excursions.
Next up, we're going to see Mr. Whitney. I think he's practicing his basketball skills.
Hello all, welcome to the Mount St. Pat's community. My name's Tim Whitney, sports coordinator here at school. I'm here tonight to tell you just a little bit about what we offer here at sport for your son or daughter. In term one, in 2021, all being well, we're going to offer representative trials. We compete in a lot of diocesan sports, as well as a competition called Northern Rivers Catholic Colleges, or NRCC for short. So in term one, kids will get an option with a lot of sporting opportunities for them. They need to pick one or two sports and trial for those. But if your son or daughter isn't that involved, they have the opportunity to partake in school sports sessions. In term two, we run the Jubilee Cup, where all year 7 and 8 stay at school and compete in inter-house competitions. The Shields, if you can see them over my shoulder, for all four houses, compete against each other in small-sided games here at school and across the road on in the MFC complex. Those points are tallied and they go towards the end-of-year competition, the Champion House Trophy. In term three, we offer recreational sports. Your son and daughter get to have an opportunity to pick a sport that interests them and partake in that for the 10 weeks of term three. Bushwalking is very popular in term three. Mr. Nix gets a lot of kids interested and goes in and around the Tweed Valley, goes on lots of bushwalks. That's just one of our options. Term four, recreational sports again, more like accessing the beaches of the beautiful Tweed Valley. We send kids to learn to surf at Hastings Point. We have a surfing group at Australia's number one beach, Cabarita. We send kids to the HPC Performance Australia, Surfing Australia Centre, as well as we access South Tweed and some of our facilities up there. Our traditional pathways for sport, our swimming carnival starts very, very early in the year, next year, 2021, it's in the second week, Friday the second week. Unfortunately, as the restrictions stand now, parents, we might have to live stream it or something like that, but we won't be able to invite you as we traditionally have, but that's just the world we live in now. So our swimming, our cross country, which we compete across the road at the showground, and then our athletics down at Les Cave Oval for the first time in 2021. From there we have our traditional pathways to represent New South Wales Combined Catholic Colleges via our Lismore Sports Selection Trials. So welcome to the family. I hope your son and daughter has a great year in 2021. We're certainly looking forward to them here at school, giving them every sporting opportunity they can. Please read the newsletters. It's the best column in there, just quietly, from the sports desk. There'll be lots of information in there regarding sport and all the important upcoming dates. So I wish you the very best of luck and can't wait to get to meet you shortly. Thanks for your time. Bye.
Good
Around the college, there are shady spots to sit and eat your lunch.
Oh no, Shano, hats, quick!
Well, hello parents of our incoming Year 7s for 2021, and if there are any students out here watching this, or any grandparents or ex-students. I'm Marianne McShane, Miss McShane, and I'm the Assistant Principal of Mount St Pat's. Next year we're going to have two Assistant Principals, we're lucky, aren't we? And my portfolio will be mission and wellbeing, traditionally what comes under my ambit are things like the well-being of students, which is critical, of course, and things like uniform and some of the sort of rules and regulations, I suppose, of coming to the college. So I've got some beautiful models, live models, who've been paid a lot of money to come and show you the uniform of the college. So I think we've got a good uniform that's I think it's pretty comfortable and it's good for our weather. The boys might not agree, but it is something that we take pride in. And so just so that you know, I've got the models to come and show you the dress uniform. So they might come through here. Look, they're gorgeous. And just turn and face the camera there. Beautiful. So this is the junior uniform. Obviously, when the students go into the senior school, they get white shirts and the girls get a tie on theirs. But they're looking glamorous, aren't they? So they've got lovely, normal black polishable shoes, just traditional. They don't have high heels or what do you call those, clips or badges or anything on them. They're not platformed or any of that stuff. So they probably could do with a bit more boot polish on their shoes. But the lads have a tucking shirt. They love that, and a belt. Philippos is looking good, and he's got his sharp haircut, looking nice. We have a rule about hair that just, if it's touching your collar, it needs to be tied back. Everyone loves that, particularly the girls, the senior girls. They like that because they can't do their model material stuff. So over blouse for the girls, and we want the skirts to be below the knee when they're standing up. So of course they all do this and they go down, but you can see how this one probably could go down, because what's happened is the girls have all grown this year, but that has to be covering the knee. So this needs to come down a little bit, but that'll be okay. Now, in terms of jewellery and things, it's one silver or gold ring, one for boys and girls, one silver or gold bracelet, a silver or gold necklace with or without a small medallion, a watch. These people don't have their watches on because they rely on their computers and or phones, which get locked away in their lockers. What else am I going to tell them about them? They're gorgeous, so, and they don't need any makeup or any aftershave or things like that to make them more glamorous than they really are. So thank you to my beautiful people who are wearing this is the dress uniform. You can buy a tie, boys, if they want to, but that's not a part of the uniform. And when I show you the sport uniform, you can purchase a tracksuit, but that's not part of the uniform. So I'll bring the people with the unisex sport uniforms. So you might just stand over there, my darlings. Come on, two other gorgeous people, paid a lot of money, paid a big amount of money. So it's a unisex uniform, although we do have now better cuts of the shorts because we've got different shaped bodies in boys and girls, as you probably know. So they've got their hats on. We have a hats policy when we're outside in the yard or doing sport or any outside activities. It's a sun safe policy, and hopefully I'd ask please that you put your student's name on everything that they have, particularly hats, because sometimes the tags get ripped, so it needs to be put in different places. So shorts, over shirt, good joggers, so just hold your foot up there, darling. Ones that are going to support the ankles and that have a bit of cushioning for you running around, 105 steps top to bottom, so you've got to get around. And this young man, he's looking very debonair. He's got his hat over his beautiful face. He's got different coloured joggers, no problem with that. And he's got the socks, the school socks, and the dress uniform socks that our little one had on before have the MSPC on the side, so they're the white socks. But is that all I need to say about the sport uniform? The students usually like to wear the sport uniform. Okay, thank you, my friends. You can go that way. And just the last thing I'd say is that we provide the students with a diary when they first come to the school. Obviously, this is this year's. And that's the way that they can be organised, to have their timetable written in it, so that you know when they've got to wear their sport uniform, because sport's on Tuesdays, but when they have prac PE, we don't do the changing over the clothes during the day at school. even though we've got the facilities to do that, takes too much time. So they've got the timetable, they can write in their stuff, and you're allowed to write messages back to teachers or to have a look if they've been at the sick bay or come late, gone early, all those things that maybe could be interesting for you to know and to comment on. We sign the diaries on Thursdays, the teachers, for the week that's gone, and we ask that you had signed the diary for the week that's gone and have a look at what you're signing, what's there, and also the uniform. The dress uniform is checked on Thursdays because that's when most of the school, getting a bit big now, but the most of the school is in their dress uniform. Okay, I look forward to meeting you. And you can contact me at any time if you've got any questions about uniform or welfare issues or just want to ask a question about how things are going. You're entering into a new stage of your lives, so get ready. This transition from, you know, primary to high school is an interesting one, an interesting one. So some of you have had older children will know that you might have a few bumps. And those of you who are, this is your first child, you are yet to experience those things. But you'll come out the other end okay, and they will, and as long as we work together with our students. Okay, bye now.
Here we can find the coordinator's offices.
Let's go find Mr. Shields.
Hi guys, my name's Louise Shields and I'm the leader of student welfare at Mount St. Pat's. Transitioning to high school is really important for your child. We need to focus on them experiencing the best feelings of belonging in order to promote confidence and engagement here at school. We have a few activities that will assist us with that. Hopefully, all being well in terms of COVID, we'll have a Currumbin excursion at the start of next year for the sole purpose of the kids getting to know each other and to building old relationships and even new ones, hopefully. We have some lunchtime activities to promote peer connections. Our hope is in 2021 that new parents into the school can form a really solid partnership between students and teachers here at Mount St. Pat's so that we can work together as a team. The importance of positive relationships is crucial, and we want to teach kids how to best enter these relationships, how to navigate new and challenging situations, and to assist with this, there'll be some wellbeing lessons which will be timetabled into your child's curriculum next year. Some of the welfare topics will include goal setting, anti-bullying, and how to deal with certain pressures here at school, building their own resilience, how to navigate cyber smartly and safely, how to build positive mental health and how to regulate emotions, all which will assist in the school setting but also will be great skills for life in general. The purpose of the welfare structure here at Mount St. Pat's is twofold. I guess it's to increase the growth personally of the kids, but also the idea that kids need to work within boundaries. So we'll try to have really clear expectations and consequences which match certain rules that have been breached within the college or within a safe, caring environment. The welfare structure here at Mount St. Pat's will include the homeroom teacher, who your child will meet with at the start of every single day for roll call and administration type duties. But most importantly, this person is the first teacher that your child will have contact with in the day. So we see the homeroom teacher as forming a really crucial part of the wellbeing team. As well as that, we'll have classroom teachers, and your child will also have a house coordinator. So by now they would have been allocated to a house, and that house coordinator will be the person in charge of their overall well-being here at the college, and they'll also be the person who will probably do most of the contacting home if there was a discipline incident at the college. And then my role at the school is to oversee all the students at the college in terms of safe behaviour and also well-being lessons. Let's go take a look at the Wellbeing Hub. So here's our space where kids can come and chill out if they need to have some time out of class or if they need to see a coordinator. So we'll have a receptionist here. In here are some rooms where they will either do some work if they're on suspension or if they need to calm down if they're in a heightened situation. And it's manned here by our receptionist, but all our coordinators. So we've got Mr. McCormack from Lucan House and Miss McPhail, Loretto House.
Hello.
Mr. Grant, Nagel House. Mr. Lynch is your 12 coordinator. And in here, missing in action, are two of the other coordinators, Mrs. Swift and Lejour coordinator, Miss Baldini. So this is where it all happens. This is where your child can come and speak to the people who will very much care for your children here at Mount St. Pat's.
Next up, we're going to find Miss Webster,
the Learning Technology Coordinator.
At Mount St. Patrick College, we're aiming to arm our students with the 21st century technological skills that will prepare them to thoroughly participate in the brave new world. That requires collaboration, creativity, perseverance, and flexibility. Through our chosen device, the very robust and powerful HP 360 hybrid tablet laptop computer, our vision is to nurture ethically conscious, lifelong learners who are adaptable in an ever-changing technological landscape. We endeavour to make creators rather than passive consumers. Here's just a taste of some of the ways that we are using technology at Mount St. Patrick College, and we look forward to seeing you here next year.
MSPC is wild.